Welcome to Engineering Scale Models. Jason, your host, and I do models. Well, I botched that intro. Well, we're going to go with it anyways. So, a while back, when I was learning Arduino and I was messing around with a little claw arm that still needs some troubleshooting, and I'll show that, how to troubleshoot something you built in a future video. But it's a little claw arm, and it sits on a little base with suction cups, and I thought, well, it'd be cool if I got a little mobile platform and I could drive around a little claw arm. So I found this. It was on Amazon. It was pretty cheap, and it is just a Drobot mobile platform. It doesn't say it's the four wheel, but it doesn't say what, anything other than that on the box. So let's open it up and take a look inside and see if we can't do something with it. So we have some wheels, we have a platform, we have another platform, and let's get this box out of here. Let's see what's in this box. Okay, so we got some motors and electronics in here. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 motors and some connectors and some battery pack. So I'm not seeing instructions or a microcontroller. That's interesting. So, and it's got a lot of configurations for the mobile platform base. So I thought for sure it came with a microcontroller, but apparently it does not. But the claw unit does come with a microcontroller, so open up one of these motors and see what we have here. So it's just a motor. It's going to need a driver, whether to go forward or backwards. It does appear to be four-wheel drive. Those are going to be a tight fit. Okay, let's take a look at how these. So this is going to go like this, and assume they go like that. Okay, well, that's one thing. How are we connecting them? I only see two screw holes. So let's take a look at the screw bag here. Let's see some hookup wire. Some two tiny screws, some platform bolts. These must be what they want to use for the motors. So let's just see if we can't hook this up here. Wow, that is a lot of screw. Wow. Screw. I'm just going to temporarily put this together and see if we can make it do something. But man, that is a lot of screw. Actually, I'm going to put the lock washers on the metal side. Regular washers on the plastic side. I like my lock washers to bite into metal. So I'm going to put a little washer here. Washer, whatever you want to say it. Yeah. I don't have the best proper English. Brain damage will do that to you. So there. Like I said, this comes with absolutely no instructions. So, we're just gonna figure out what we can do here. Wow, I almost pinged that washer all over the place. Grip it like that. I said I am not a fan of these. Just just grab a pair of their screwdriver here. Lock washers are nice. I guess that's gonna be alright. That's gonna clear if the tire goes on. Like I said, those tires are gonna be an insane fit. So, that's how the motors are gonna work. So, there's gonna be some tricky coating on the motors. Because they're all gonna be, you know, there's going to be a left front of, you know, all the different locations. So we're going to take a look at the other stuff that we have here. Seems like decent hardware. Worst comes to worst, I have tons of hardware, so that's why I was like, when I got this, I made sure I had some hardware in case I needed to edit or change this. Everything seems to be in these anti-static bags, which is good. So we have some more, 4 more long bolts, some spacers, and some star-looking wafers. And we have a signal 5 volts ground on a chip that is horribly placed. ENC. Shows there's a diode under there. But here's what this board looks like. It's got signal 5 volts and ground. So pin 2 is 5 volts, 3 is ground, and what is signal? There are 2 of these boards and the clips that go with them with female headers. Okay. I prefer the male headers. And this is just a battery pack. Got a power jack. We have a switch. This is to turn it on. This wire is going to hook all that up. But the power jack, this is strange. There's just 4 more motors. I'm going to open everything up and show you what I have here. This just seems like missing a lot of components to make this do anything. Like, there's no motor control chips. Like, no H-bridges. That's what's missing, is H-bridges. So, I have some. I have those. But it's weird that, and I don't know, I'm not sure what these are. It appears to be some form of chip. Let's see if I can read what that chip is. It's a C14K. Looks to be some sort of MOSFET or something. This can't be the motor driver. It can't be. There'd have to be more to it. There does appear to be something. ENC. So there's a diode underneath this board, and it says C and E. That has to be collector and emitter, I would assume. I'm not sure what that is, but there is a diode in there. Is that some form of H bridge? And why is there only two of them? One for the front, one for the back? And this one is just so wonky, it's not even going to fit. I just want to know what's in there. Let me see here. Okay. It looks like it could possibly be an optical encoder. It's got the two LEDs that read each other, but they're housed in this case like this. So it's fitting better now. And not sure what it would go on to read. I'm not sure what it would go on to read at all. It can't, it fits on there, but it doesn't. This is strange. No instructions, nothing on the internet. This is some kind of weird encoder. Figured it out. So this goes on here, and on this shaft you screw one of these wafer discs, and it keeps track of your revolutions. So whether they would go on the front or the back, I'm not sure. It only comes with the two. So we're going to look into this. So we got some, not rotary encoders, but encoders to find the location of the orientation of the wheels and to see how many times they turn. But the thing is, would you want that on the front and the back? And which one of these is the front and which one's the back? It's got a little bumper, so I guess that could be the front. You can mount a board here. Let's see how this goes up here like this. Yeah. matches two holes. So this platform goes on here like this. So that's what it looks like. So whatever side you want to be the front and the back, it does look like it will fit my claw thing. And the claw has a board on it with extra inputs. So I'll have to hack down the probe, the programming on that. Alright, so I'm going to pause right here and I am going to go get that claw thing. And I'll be back in a second. Okay guys, I'm back. I got the little claw mechanism here thingy, and here it is right here. It has a claw arm. It runs on four different servos here, and it does five servos because it rotates too. So it has an Arduino board with a breakout board shield on top. It does turn on and it does crazy things like that, and I can, you know, I can make adjustments and move things, but it's very slow reaction. So like I said, it works. It does random things. I don't know what the touch button does, but it had an LCD screen here, and me not paying attention, I plugged the LCD screen into the wrong way. So I do have another LCD screen here that it's a little OLED display. Looks like this. I have a couple of them to make sure this is hooked up correctly. It goes this way, I believe. Ground. It would go like this, but I'm not going to hook it up until I make sure the clock and signal are correct on here. Let's see, this is 5 volts, and this is ground. So that's now correct. And then I could hook it up correctly with this, like this, because the ground and VCC are hooked up correctly, 5 volts. But I have to double check to make sure this isn't a 3.3 volt LED or OLED. And I have another one that is the same. I have a couple of those. Probably have more somewhere else. They're only like $3 or $4. But I need to hook that back up there, so I'll get to that. But I want to talk about this project here, and this is just something stupid. I got a lot of stupid things going on. That's what I want. My wife's always mad. So I'm assuming this, not with the suction cups, but you know, I could probably find a way to get these angular holes and some holes back here to line up, maybe, you know, and then just try to find a way to, because there's a couple different holes here that I can plug into. If I look at center of those two holes, I can line those up. So there's, you know, a couple different options we could try. You know, try to figure something out. Might have to double slot some stuff, but that's my goal, to put this robot arm thing on this driving thing, and then I should have access. I have to trace back where all these servos, what pins they're using, and why is, for some reason, the the touch button is being plugged into the Bluetooth receiver. That doesn't seem right. So it must have gotten moved. So I probably shouldn't have turned that on. So I think I have a schematic stored on the computer for this. So I am gonna check that out. Let's see if we can find a wiring schematic for this in my documents. What is it? An Arduino, probably. What's the brand of that? Adept. Robot arm. There we go. Of course. Alright. Let's... I'm just trying to get this file up here. So anyway, so yeah, so that's what I want to get going here, is to get this hooked up and working so I can basically play with it, maybe hook up a joystick interface to it, and things like that. Robot arm. I should be able to pull this now. Yeah, it's just going to download it from my cloud. It's all in the cloud for some reason. Actually, when I built this the first time, I was on the old computer system and I didn't have this this computer set up. So luckily I use everything in the Microsoft cloud. So here we go. Let me put this on monitor one. And here we go. We have the Adept robot arm. All the pieces, we did all that. I just want to see the hookup for so that's if you want to do with the serial output. Okay, I want to see the I'm just going to go up here to table of contents and find out where assembly .4, which is page 47. The servos. Does it say to put the switches on up here? Okay, can't say to hook up the switches yet. I just want to troubleshoot this thing so we can... So connect the servos, we did that. Okay, anode red wire, yep. That's that, we have power. Now we have to build that. We built all the arms. This thing was a pain in the butt to build, let me tell you. This took me, and I didn't have a workbench at the time, so I built it in like an easy chair, and it was not easy. Okay, here we go. So let's just grab that OLED display and see what happens. So I have to, so if I fry it, then So we have here, it's off, so if I hook this up to this way, if I plug this in like so, I have ground power, which is ground is black, power is 3.3 volts, I need 5 volts. So 5 volts. And then clock, which is yellow. Make sure that's the same. Yellow goes to A5, and then the other one goes to A4. Yeah, I guess that touch switch does go where the Bluetooth is. Ground at 5 volts, okay. So, I'm not going to screw down that OLED display. I need to make this stuff more permanent when I get this working. Okay, so that's that. It's going to sit like that. Okay. Well, let's see what happens when I turn it on now. It's going to do that crazy thing. And the screen is all iffy. Okay, it says current state, learning status, so remaining steps 10. Let me get my screwdriver out of here so I can control these better. Okay, what does this one do? So that seems to move the base. That moves the arm down and opens it and closes it, so doesn't like that movement. So this one, moves that joint. This one, moves that joint. So that one doesn't have a full range of movement. Okay. And the step thing doesn't work. It is hooked up to 5 volts of ground. It's getting power. So, learning step 6. So there's really no other buttons on this, so I am going to have to control it with the software. So that's gonna wrap it up. I'm gonna go back over here. So like, you couldn't see this because I didn't switch the screen, but this seems to rotate it. Rotate that, but it doesn't have the full degrees of motion. These seem more like tweaking things. And if I turn this one, it moves that down. And if I tweak it more this way, but it seems more of a tweaking thing, because this one moves the next one down and opens the claw. And it is super delayed. That rotates it. There's a super delay in there. That MOSFET's not getting hot. So, I need to find out what pins this program is using. Unfortunately, you can't plug this in and get the code that was on it. So I'm going to go in here and research it and see if I can't, make a driving Clawbot. That's what I'm going to do. Alright guys, thank you so much. You can visit me on social media. You can also visit my Patreon page. I'm doing a cool thing now. $25, you get a cool custom sanding stick, and you get an IC a month, and some data sheets on it, and information on cool stuff you can build with it. And I also have a GoFundMe, so I can try to get me some lab equipment, pay for the stuff that's on loan to me, and also get some additional stuff like an electronic load and things like that, because I have some cool projects coming up and I need the equipment to do it. But it's going to be stuff you can do at home, but I need the equipment to do the test and make sure everything works out so I can have PC boards printed and all kinds of cool stuff like that. So any support would be helpful. The links are in the description.